Welcome to MCN and the Kawasaki ZX-10R SE. Now, this bike sits at the top of the ZX-10 range, above the ZX-10R and the ZX-10RR. And the headline facts about this bike is that it's got Showa semi-active electronic suspension. Now, this is a first for Kawasaki, and it's a first for Showa in a road bike as well. And the general idea is inside the forks and the shock, you've kind of got an electronic screwdriver, and that's twiddling with the rebound compression damping adjusters all the time you're riding. So that's based on your road speed, your lean angle, your wheel speeds, brake pressure, all that kind of stuff. That sets the damping control. Now, the reason Kawasaki have gone down this route with ZX-10, and the reason a lot of bike manufacturers have put in semi-active suspension on their bikes, is because when you've got a suspension setting, you basically just got one setting, and that one setting has to do you for all kinds of conditions. It has to do you for bumpy roads, smooth roads, riding fast, riding slow, and it also is a one size fits all, so not everyone's the same size, they don't ride in the same way. So unless you actually adjust your suspension and you know how to do it, which, let's be honest, not many people really do, and those who do haven't really got the inclination, most of us are stuck with the suspension settings that you get out of the showroom, which are a massive compromise. And generally on the soft side as a sort of a worst case scenario. So Kawasaki have got this system in the ZX-10R now. They're not the first people to come out with an electronic suspended superbike. BMW were there first with the 2013 HP4, and that was SAC's suspension. That's carried on in their S1000RR. And more recently, you've got Olin's semi-active units in the Blade SP, the Panigale 1299S, the Panigale V4, and the Yamaha R1M. So as well as electronic suspension on this bike, you get a few nice little goodies from the ZX-10RR, namely the lightweight Marchesini wheels, and the quick shifter and auto blipper off the RR as well. The standard ZX-10's got the quick shifter, but not the blipper. So you get a lot for your money here, and it is expensive. It's £19,000. It's 2018 March time now, so prices will probably change. But what Kawasaki have done is left the standard high quality gas suspension shower units in place, so they haven't detracted on quality to put its silicone implants inside. So what makes this system different to all the others? Well, Kawasaki reckons this is possibly the best because rather than controlling the damping inside the suspension units with like a step motor or an indirect control solenoid, they use a direct solenoid, and that allows the suspension to react really quickly, like 1,000 times a second quickly. And it also takes readings from all of the bike's sensors, so it can harvest the same kind of crazy speed information as it actually works. It takes information from the ECU, from the inertial measurement unit. It also monitors suspension travel. So only a sum of its rivals have got a rear suspension travel. And the good thing about that is that you can see how fast the suspension's moving and how far it's moving and whether it's moving up or down. So that will control compression or rebound. But Kawasaki is the first road bike to have the travel sensor in the front forks. Now, you'll probably see them on race bikes. There's like a potentiometer that sits on the outside of the forks, which is no good for the road because they're not very durable. But they've got one in the inside of the damping fork leg, the left-hand fork leg, so that measures front suspension control. So this system is faster. It takes more information from parameters inside the bike, and it should give you more control. So on the road, one of the Kawasaki ZX-10's best bits are the fact the suspension is so plush, and that's still there to a point, but it is a little bit firmer because the suspension's always working to give you the best control depending on your speed, and it's supporting you under acceleration, it's supporting you under braking, So the plushness is still there, but you've got sort of a lighter suspension feel. The bike kind of feels a little bit perkier because out the crate, even though we all know ZX-10s win world championships and BSB races and all sorts of things, it's not the most sparkling of all the superbikes. It's quite kind of dull's probably the wrong word, but it doesn't accelerate with the ferocity of you'd expect from a superbike. It doesn't steer with the speed, doesn't brake as sharply, but it has got a load of good bits. The suspension's really plush, the electronics are absolutely superb, and once you've got that bike wound up, it's not slow by any stretch of the imagination. So on the road, the electronic suspension does give you a slightly kind of perkier ride. I actually tried it in race mode on the road, and the steering became really fast, really crisp, and I really enjoyed the feeling, but it's no surprise that the ride quality suffered. So there's two riding modes, there's road and track, and you enter those via the dash in a kind of quite a clumsy way. It doesn't really change within the riding modes like it does on some rivals, so you've got to stop, whiz through the dash, choose your mode. So there's road and track, which I tried, but there's also a manual mode. So I think if I had this bike, I would choose a setting somewhere between road and track that gives me the kind of the plush ride I want, with the steering that is really enjoyable as well. The great thing about the electronic suspension is that when you're not riding like Johnny Ray down your favourite bit of road, you can just click it into a soft mode, and then the bike's sort of nice and plush. Now, we also rode the bike on the track at Almeria, and again, the idea is you click a button and the suspension is set harder for you. Now, we actually had it in manual mode, which Kawasaki dialed in before we got there to suit the track and the conditions and the tyres. We used Bridgestone R11 track tyres, which are stickier than the RS10s that come as standard. It has to be said that the preload still has to be mechanically adjusted, so you still need to set the sag up on the bike to go on the track for best results. So you still kind of need to know what you're doing there. And it does improve things. It makes the bike a lot livelier, a lot more direct, a lot more stable, gives it more ground clearance. It's kind of win-win-win, really. And we actually tried it on road settings just to see what the difference was, and there is a massive difference between road and track, which is really good. It shows the level of the quality of the suspension there. Now, some of the benefits of the electronic suspension are kind of masked a little bit by the fact that the Kawasaki's got a few little quirks on track. So the throttle is quite snatchy, which you really notice when you're full lean, so that kind of sets the bike off a little bit. The brakes ultimately have stopping power, but they lack that kind of really nice tactile feel that you get with European superbikes, which none of the Japanese bikes seem to have. We disconnected the ABS because the ABS can be quite intrusive on the ZX-10. And the engine doesn't really have much in the way of low down grunt, and the gear is very tall, so it doesn't fire out of corners like a superbike should. So all of those factors kind of mask what the suspensions do, really. So it's hard to compare it to a much sportier blade, a much lighter blade, the much more kind of aggressive and racy Ducatis, or the much stronger BMW. But it does transform the Kawasaki, and it is perfect for track day riders who don't actually want to adjust their suspension or haven't got the inclination to do it. But I would say that if you're a proper circuit head and you're always on track, then you're probably better with like aftermarket suspension, which is dialed in to suit the rider, which has got bespoke springs to suit the rider. The only negative I can find on the electronic suspension as it is that the feel you get when you're trailing the brakes, that kind of last little bit as you're digging into the corner, isn't quite there. It feels a little bit dead. But that aside, what Kawasaki have done here is really given you three bikes in one. They've given you a bike that you can just enjoy nice and comfortably on motorways, just going from A to B. You can firm it up to enjoy your favourite roads, and you can ride it on track, all at the press of a button, which is very clever stuff.